Good morning, students. This is class 11, subject chemistry, chapter 2, structure of atom, lecture number 1. So topics of today's lecture are general introduction, discovery of electron, proton and neutron, and to determine mass of electron. So general introduction, we know that atom consists of subatomic particles, electron, proton, neutron. But by the end of 19th century, there were major questions in front of scientists that what is the reason for the stability of atom? Why behavior of one element is different from other in terms of chemical properties and physical properties? Why do atoms combine to form molecule? And what is the origin and nature of the electromagnetic radiation? Discovery of electron. So William Crookes, he was a scientist. In 1879, he studied the conduction of electricity through gases at low pressure. For this, he took a discharge tube. In the discharge tube, there were two electrodes. One was cathode, another one was anode. And a vacuum pump was present there to adjust the pressure. And gas was present in the glass tube. So when the pressure is reduced to 1 mm to 10 mm, or we can say 10 to the power minus 2 atmosphere, then the current starts flowing between the electrodes and a colored glow is also observed. Now the color depends on the nature of the gas. As you can see here, the rays, okay, they are passing from the cathode to anode. When the pressure is further reduced to about 0.01 mm, then the glow between the electrodes, it will disappear, but the current continues to flow. Now here, as you can see here, the anode is perforated. That means there are holes in anode. Okay, these are the holes in anode. So when rays which are coming from the cathodes, they will pass through the anode, then they will strike at this point. Okay. And a greenish glow is observed. Here, zinc sulfide material is used here for the greenish glow. Now, these invisible cathode rays, which are coming from the cathodes, they are known as cathode rays. Next one is properties of cathode rays. So, first property is that they travel in straight line. So, for this, we will place here a solid object in the path of cathode rays, and a zinc sulfide screen is also placed here. Okay, so you will observe that shadow of the object will fall on the zinc sulfide screen. So it shows that they travel in straight line. Second property is that cathode rays are made of material particle. So when a light wheel is placed here in the discharge tube, so cathode rays, they will strike the light wheel and the wheel starts to rotate. It means that cathode rays are made of material particles. Third property is that cathode rays carry negative charge. For this, we will provide here electric field. So here there is positive plate and here there is negative plate. So when cathode rays pass through the hole of anode, then they will deflect towards the positively charged plate. As they are deflecting towards positively charged plate, that means cathode rays carry negative charge. In the same way, if we apply magnetic field, then the cathode rays will deflect in that direction, which will show that cathode rays carry negative charge. Fourth property is the cathode rays produce heating effect. Because when they strike to a metal foil, then the latter will become hot. Fifth point, they possess penetrating effect. Now we will define what is electron. So the negatively charged material particles constituting the cathode rays are called electrons. Here, to determine mass of an electron, this formula is used, that mass of an electron is equal to E divided by E by M. So to determine mass of electron, we should know what is charge of electron and what is E by M ratio. So here E, charge of electron, is determined by Millikan's experiment, and E by M, charge to mass ratio of electron, is determined by J.J. Thomson's experiment. When we will put values, then here mass of electrons comes equal to 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. So what is Thomson's experiment? So Thomson's experiment, it was used to determine E by M ratio, that means charge to mass ratio. So here this is the apparatus. In this apparatus, cathode is present here, anode is present here with a hole, and electrical field is applied here with the help of these two plates. One is positive plate, one is negative plate, and these two plates, they are connected to circuit, and this is a magnet which is used to provide magnetic field. So now, in the presence of only electric field, these cathode rays, they will deflect towards positively charged plate, because cathode rays, they are negatively charged. That is why the deflection will be towards positively charged plate. So deflection will be at point A. Now, in the presence of only magnetic field, the deflection of cathode rays, it will be at point C. And when electric and magnetic field both are balanced, then cathode rays, they will strike at point B. That means they will travel in straight line. This deflection of electron depends on three factors. First is charge of electron, second is mass of electron, and third one is strength of electric and magnetic field. From the calculation, we came to know that ratio of E by M is equal to E by H square R. Here, capital E is equal to strength of electric field, H is strength of magnetic field, and here R is the radius of electron as it moves through the magnetic field. So as you can see here, that this curve path, this is the radius. Okay. So from this experiment, we can find out value of E by M. Now next experiment is Millikan's oil drop experiment for determination of charge on electron. So in this apparatus, one atomizer is used here. An X-ray source is present here. Here there is telescope, and there are two chambers in this apparatus. And one plate is this, which is positively charged, and one plate is this, which is negatively charged. These two plates, they are connected to circuit to provide electric field. Now, a spray of oil droplet is produced with the help of atomizer. This is atomizer, and spray of oil droplets is produced here in this chamber. Now, these oil droplets, they are allowed to pass through this hole. Under the influence of gravitational force, these oil droplets, they will move in downward direction. So oil droplet, it will move in downward direction. Now with the help of telescope, we will observe the rate of fall of oil droplets. And with the rate of fall of oil droplet, we can determine mass of oil droplets. Okay. Now the X-ray source, it will produce X-rays, and the gas which is present in this chamber, it will ionize. The gas will ionize, and one or two electrons are captured by this oil droplet, and the oil droplet will acquire negative charge. As the oil droplet acquires negative charge, so this oil droplet, it will be attracted to positively charged plate in upward direction. Okay, that means there is an electrical force which is attracting oil droplet in upward direction. But there is also another force, which is gravitational force, which is attracting oil droplet in downward direction. So here there are two forces. One is attracting oil droplet in upward direction, and another one is attracting oil droplet in downward direction. So by adjusting the voltage the oil droplet, it will become stationary. Now we already know what is the mass of oil droplet. So by knowing the charge on the plate, we can determine charge on electron. So it is found that charge was always a small whole number multiple of minus 1.60 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Okay, so as you can see here, that mass of the oil droplet, it is already known with the help of rate of fall of oil droplet in downward direction. And charge on the plates, we can find out that. And with the help of these, charge on the droplets were determined, and it is found that charge was always a small whole number multiple of minus 1.60 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulombs. So this is Millikan's oil drop experiment. Now next one is discovery of neutron. So Chadwick in 1932 performed some scattering experiment in which he bombarded some light elements like beryllium and boron with fast moving alpha particles. So here we are using this word alpha particles. So what is alpha particles? Alpha particles are positively charged particles which carries plus 2 charge and mass 4 unit. In another words, we can say that it is nuclei of helium. He found that new particles were emitted, carried no charge, and these particles was termed as neutrons. So here, as you can see here, that these are the alpha particles, okay? And we can also say that alpha particles are nuclei of helium. So we can write it like helium 2, 4. Charge is 2 and mass is 4. So when alpha particle strikes beryllium atom or boron atom, then what will happen? There will be formation of new particles which will carry no charge and mass is 1 unit. Okay, so N01, this new particle, it is known as neutron. So here we will define what is neutron. The particles which carries no charge but has a mass nearly equal to that of hydrogen atom or proton is known as neutron. After the discovery of electron, there was a need of positively charged particles also, because atom is electrically neutral. So Goldstein in 1886 performed an experiment. He took a discharge tube in which two electrodes were present. One was anode, another one was cathode. He took a perforated cathode. The red rays which are coming out from the cathode, they are cathode rays. But he observed that there are some rays which are coming from the anode and they strike to the zinc sulfide coating. So these rays which are coming from the anode, they are known as anode rays. They are also known as canal rays because they are passed from the canals of cathode or holes of cathodes. So these rays are known as anode rays or canal rays. Now properties of anode rays. So anode rays, they travel in straight line. They are made of material particles. They are positively charged. The value of E by M, that means charge to mass ratio, is found to be different for different gases. Fifth one is that the mass of the particle constituting the anode rays is also found to be different for different gases. Here we will define what is proton. So the fundamental particle which carries 1 unit positive charge and has a mass nearly equal to the hydrogen atom is known as proton. So that's all for today, students. Now your homework is that you have to read Discovery of Electron, Proton and Neutron from NCERT book. Like and subscribe this channel. Thank you and have a nice day.